Welcome again to my presentation today. On behalf of the Navit project, I will talk today about how we do testing of our app, this time again with device farms, but with a bit of a change compared to last year. As Navit is a GPS navigation software, which you can use as an alternative to Google Maps, I tried to frame my talk today in the shape of a trip, like when I was traveling from where I live in Celle, Germany, here to Brussels. So for all of that, one needs a map. We mostly use OpenStreetMap data, and this is how my whole route was when I was starting in Germany and coming all down to Brussels. And if you go by car, then you start somewhere inside your car, you have your GPS map ready to start your trip, and then you enter the motorway and go on your way. Now, for our talk today, I structured it like this. That at first I give you a brief intro about Navit, then about device farms and our own device farm, Appium. And I will also mention a little bit what happened on the site, what other people in the project did during all of this time. But I will focus more on the things on the left. So what is Navit? It's an open source GPS app, which is multi-platform, covers many different platforms. It's offline, so you don't need any online connection during the operation, just once for downloading the maps. We use, as I already mentioned, OpenStreetMap data. We have been around already quite a while, more than 10 years now. And advantage for the end user is, as it's open source, it's highly customizable. It also does not need that much computing power, so you can also use pretty old devices. You can change the map layout, the on-screen display, so which elements you want to have where, routing profiles. And also we have different text-to-speech systems. And the last point here, translations in many languages. This is always something where we also value community contributions a lot, because we are just a small team and we just speak a handful of languages. So if you really want to have it localized in a large number of languages, you need to rely on volunteers. So if anyone here wants to contribute, we have it on Launchpad. Please feel free to, because that will help everyone in the end. So what has happened since my talk last year? We improved the map server, which is used to transform the OpenStreetMap data for others to download. We resolved some issues in the map rendering. For example, we had some overflooding of areas which should be land because the map data was not good enough. We worked on the translations. What I find most remarkable is that we still work on the traffic branch, which more or less does that we can have messages about traffic jams, blocked roads, or other problems when you are driving, and that can then be used to adapt the route dynamically. So that is something really nice, and what I mostly worked on was the implementation of our new device farm. Why do we do a device farm in the first place? If you make a mobile phone app, usually you have a large number of different devices. The app is installed on Android. On top has a very large beauty that you have a fragmentation of many different Android versions. Right now we support, if I remember correctly, back till Android 2.3, so you have a lot to cover, and testing is not really that simple, because if you can just test locally, you just have, each developer maybe has some devices, but you cannot share it or use it more on a global way, or maybe others could also provide devices, but if it's always in one place, needs to be in one place of the developer working on it, it's pretty difficult. And if one looks at iPhones, which are not our focus right now, then that might also not be available to everyone. So a device farm gives you the opportunity to have a web interface where you can imagine you have maybe one server or several servers, and to those you have the different mobile phones connected, and then via a central interface you can access all of them. You can run, for example, UI-based tests. That's what I will talk about today. You can manually do the actions on the phone, and you could also compare the performance of different devices, maybe to see which is the weakest, for which one could do more optimization. Commercially, quite a few are available. Microsoft offers one, Google, Amazon, and a few more, but all of those have some limitations, of course, which we try to overcome. And those are, of course, you are completely bound to what the vendor is offering you. Which phones are there, which functionality is there, you continuously need to pay in an abonnement or kind of reoccurring costs, which for a small open source project is also not that easy. And you cannot also not extend the functionality. So we said we want something on our own, and the Open SDF project offers with SDF a platform which you can install and just connect your phones, and you have exactly the functionality which we want. And that's what I was mostly looking at, how to work with that. Right now, we want to have it in a distributed fashion, as I already mentioned. One developer has the Intel NUC, and one has a dedicated x86 server. So for those, the implementation was pretty simple. There's a Docker image, which you just need to run, and things work, and everything is nice and smooth. For the connection of the different nodes, we want to do it via an VPN, because OpenSDF, despite having all the functionality, you don't want to expose such things out to the internet without any access control. Still, because they are not focusing too much on security. And for embedded devices, that was what I was more looking at, to deploy it more widely, like with the Raspberry Pi. We said we want to have the dedicated server as master and all other nodes more or less as a slave. And in the final stage, it should be triggered like a general continuous integration system. So for the deployment, that I mostly covered already. What I used was a Raspbian-based image, but we also looked and also plan to look into maybe using OpenWRT to also have a larger number of devices we could address, but that's more future work. And when I did it with the Raspberry Pi, it was, as I said, I used Raspbian, and I had to actually install two different packages. At first, RethinkDB, which is a backend database. And RethinkDB has a downside that it's not too largely developed anymore. It's still somehow maintained. And they mostly offer packages just for Intel platforms, not for any Raspberry Pi. But they have a community manual to compile it for Raspberry Pi. And the earlier versions, 1, 2, 3 of Raspberry Pi, have not sufficient memory, so you need to adjust also swap. And yeah, it takes some time for compiling. But all of that I have done, and also made a complete image, which we can also then distribute to any user who wants to donate us, so to speak, some devices that we can grow our platform. If you manage everything, then the web interface will look like this here, where you have at the left, at the top, the different devices. If you click on it, then you can manually control it. And you can also run automated tests, which I will partially show today. Then Appium, I wanted to use to do these automated tests like last year, for the reason that it also supports quite a large number of platforms, has clients for many different programming languages, and it's also an open source library. And when looking this year into Appium, I also noticed that there are some features which I wished to have already last year or to know about them. You can do screen recording, just also in the Python code, do screenshots, and even make a graphical comparison. So if you have a sample picture, and then if something changes, then you see, okay, something obviously went wrong. So those features seem pretty exciting, and I just got to know about them this year. And I did some initial implementation steps and ran some first simple tests, like downloading the map, which you would do anyway if you start using Navit. Here is how a sample code, which does some of the things, also some more things. And this is just how you would do it in Python. But as I mentioned, you can also use Java, Ruby, or many other languages. And then here I have a video demo does that work? This is how it worked then when I was doing the animation. So now it was already starting, and just by the Python code, I download now the maps of the Azure Islands. That takes a couple of seconds, so maybe I skim a bit forward, and then at the end you have the screen, and then one could compare, okay, did it really do what I wanted it to, or did it crash somewhere in between, and then see on which device did it crash, and by that just giving you a lot more tools at hand to really make your code more mature. And here was one screenshot which I also took by the Python code. And that already brings me pretty close to the end of my talk. And it's mostly Android OpenSDF, but our project is not just limited to Android. We have Linux, we have Sailfish OS, Android, of course, Windows it's running on, Windows CE, TomTom, but OpenSDF cannot...
No apples and pears and so on.
Not that many. Is it
supported
We had an Apple port for Navit, but I don't think it's very well maintained. I would say STS supports also Apple devices. So if someone would give us an iPhone, then, or connect one, it could also help other people looking into that port more. But you know, all depending on time and interest.
Yeah, yeah. Just wanted to know whether it's supported at all.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Yeah, please.
Could I also set up my own slave on this app and then connect to your master?
Yes, that's the idea behind, actually.
Okay.
Wow. That is the idea behind. It's not fully functional yet, but we want to get there.
Okay. So I could share my device with other projects and just...
Yes.
Where do I find information? How, if I'm interested in sharing,
we will have a documentation about it. But right now, it's not fully functional yet. So that will be on our website certainly, okay, or in our wiki. Yes.
Anyway, different question. Where do you get the traffic information?
That is via. That radio signal, TFMC, or I don't remember now.
And is it already integrated in Navit, or we
have a branch for it where it's actually also running, but it's still a bit in an experimental shape. It's not in the main branch yet. But people are working on it, and I'm pretty excited also about it.
Okay. Anybody else? If not, well, thank you very much.